Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, Chemistry PhD, Skincare Nerd, and Pimply Person. When I was a teenager, I assumed I'd grow out of it and I'd be pimple-free by my 30s, but that was a lie. But there have been a lot of really good products that have come out for treating pimples that I really wish I had in my teens, and one of the brands I've been using a lot is Zit Sticker. They make these really neat stickers for targeting spots, and I'm going to talk you through my favourite products and the science behind how they work. This video is sponsored by Zit Sticker, but these are my honest opinions of the products after I've been using them for a while. I've been using the Killer Patches for a bit over a year, the Hyperfade Patches for a few months, and the Goo Getter only for a few weeks, but that's because this is their latest launch. If you like nerding out about the science behind beauty products, click the like, the subscribe, and the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Let's start with the Killer Patches. These are micro dart patches that are designed for pimples that are a bit too deep for regular topical spot treatments to get to. They have a chip with tiny spikes, or darts as they're officially called, and this is stuck to a hydrocolloid bandage. The darts have active ingredients in them, and when you put it on your skin, the darts sink a little bit into your skin, and then they dissolve, and that delivers the active ingredients deeper into your skin, closer to where they need to be to deal with the pimple. The Killer Kit has two parts. It has the cleaner cleansing wipes and the Killer Patches. You clean the area first with the cleaner wipe, and that gets rid of oil and dirt, and so the patch sticks down better. This also has actives in it that can help with the pimple, so it's got salicylic acid and tea tree oil, and these can clear out the pore and help calm down the pimple. After wiping, you stick on the patch with the dart side down. The darts dissolve within about 2 hours, and that delivers the actives. So the actives in this, they're salicylic acid again, also hyaluronic acid, which is a really great humectant moisturizer, oligopeptide 76, which is an antimicrobial peptide that's non-irritating, and niacinamide, which helps with uneven skin tone, obvious pores, and redness. So the darts will dissolve within about 2 hours, but it's better to leave the patch on for longer, so I usually put this on overnight. So leaving the patch on there actually helps the active ingredients absorb better. There's a thing where if you occlude your skin, if you cover it up with something, then active ingredients can get in more easily. The patch also protects the area so you don't pick at it as much and it stays clean. The patch also keeps the area moist, which is better for healing. I like using these patches on medium depth pimples, so not the ones that are like really hard lumps, but the ones that are a bit shallower, a little bit smaller, but they're really red and angry. These ones usually take a few days before you can start to see the pus, but I found that if you put this on early enough, the bump sort of goes backwards. With any pimple that has pus in it, I like to put on a hydrocolloid bandage. These are the pimple patches that you might have seen around. They usually come on a sheet and you peel it off and stick it on a pimple. So the sticky side has a humectant in it and that sucks up any fluid from a pimple. They also protect your pimples from dirt and they stop you from picking at them. Also, if they soak up enough fluid, you get this really satisfying white spot. Zit Sticker have just launched the Goo Getter Spot Clarifying Dots. These are hydrocolloid bandages, but unlike a lot of the other ones on the market, they also have actives in them. Like with the Killer Patches, we have salicylic acid and tea tree oil, and these clear out the clogs and calm down the pimple. There's also niacinamide that's soothing and helps with uneven skin tone. On top of that, there's also vitamin C in the form of ascorbic acid. This is an antioxidant that helps shield against free radical damage, and it also helps keep your skin tone even as the pimple heals. Again, we have that occlusion effect. When you cover up your skin, it absorbs ingredients better, even if you don't have anything like microdarts. And so having that hydrocolloid combined with the active ingredients, it's a really effective option. There's no cleaning wipe with the Goo Getter, but because it sits on top of the skin rather than sinking in, then it doesn't really need it as much. You should still make sure that you clean the skin first though, so you don't trap any dirt in there. Also make sure your skin is dry before you apply these products, otherwise the darts on the Killer Patch are just going to dissolve on top of your skin, and the Goo Getter probably won't stick. It might absorb out some of the water, and so it's not absorbing the fluid inside your pimple. The Goo Getter patches are a bit on the smaller side, so they're good for small pimples, but if you have a lot of fluid, these probably won't work as well. I'm hoping that Zit Sticker will also follow up with bigger ones too. Finally, there's also Hyperfade. This is a microdart patch that targets the dark spot that's left after your pimple goes away. Like with a lot of other Asians, I'm really prone to hyperpigmentation after pimples, so it's really good to see products that cater for this. Hyperfade uses the same hyaluronic acid-based dart technology as the Killer Patches, but there are fading ingredients in this instead. So there's kojic acid, niacinamide, vitamin C, arbutin, tranexamic acid, and licorice root extract. I've been using these on my dark acne marks, and they've been working really well. I've always had a lot of success with fading dark acne marks using ascorbic acid, vitamin C, So I'm not really surprised that these patches work so well. They have the ascorbic acid and lots of other stuff. So they have the extra active ingredients, they have the darts, and they have the occlusion. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, you can give it a thumbs up and subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram at LabMuffinBeautyScience and check out my blog for more about the science behind beauty products. See you next time to nerd out more.